Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of machine design. The topic is brake. Question number 11 and 13, 11 to 13 carries a common statement. The statement is, a simple band brake applied to a shaft carrying a flywheel of 250 kg mass and of radius of gyration 300 mm. The shaft speed is 300 rpm. The drum diameter is 200 mm. And the coefficient of friction is 0.25. Question number 11. The brake torque when a force of 120 Newton is applied at the lever end is dash. Question number 12. The time taken by the flywheel to come to rest. Question number 13. Width of the band if the thickness is 1 mm and maximum tensile stress is limited to 40 Newton per mm square. So this is the figure given. This angle is 135 and radius is 100 mm. This is 100 mm, this is 280 mm, and this is 120 mm. Okay. So as this angle is 135 degree, so angle of contact will be 360 minus 135, that is 225. So mass is given as 250 kg and the coefficient of friction is given as 0.25. Coefficient of friction is given as 0.25 and radius of gyration is given as 300 mm for the flywheel. Radius of gyration is given as 300 mm and RPM, initial RPM is given as 200 rpm and this A is your 100 mm and this L is your 2A. And radius of drum is 100 mm. So converting this angle theta into radian, that is by multiplying it by pi and dividing by 180, so that will be your 3.93 radian. Okay. Now again, as the rotation is anti-clockwise, so this will be your T1 and this will be your T2. Opposite to rotation, rotation is this in this direction. So the applied or the braking torque has to be applied in opposite direction. So when T1 is more and T2 is less, then the braking torque will be applied in clockwise direction. So this is your T1, this is your T2. So this is the forces acting on the drum, and the forces acting on the drum on the lever will be T1 and T2. Okay. So now from this angle of contact or ratio, angle of contact or tension ratio relation, we have T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Mu is 0.25 and theta is 3.93. So T1 and T2 ratio is 2.67. Now taking moment about O or this point or hinge point, we will take this T1, this T2 and 120. So T1 into 100, because this T2 is passing through this, so there is no distance for this. So okay, so will be F into L, F is your 120 into that 120 into 280 and will be equal to T1 into 100. So from this we can find out T1. So T1 will be your 336 Newton, and from this relationship we can find out T2 also. So T2 comes out as 125.8 Newton. So the braking torque will be T1 minus T2 into radian. That is 336 minus 125.8 into 0.1, that is 21 Newton. So answer, first question, braking torque is your, braking torque is your 21 Newton. Okay. So this is your braking torque, and we know that the braking torque is equal to I into alpha. So moment of inertia can be calculated by using mass as 250 kg and radius as 100 mm. So that is m k square. So it is your 250 radius of gyration is given. Sorry, radius of gyration is your 300 mm, so we'll take 0.3. That diameter is given as with that it is different and radius of gyration is different. Okay, so radius of gyration is 300 mm. So we'll take radius of gyration is 0.3. So I is your 22.5 kilogram meter square. Putting that T is equal to I into alpha. So T we have calculated as 21 newton meter converting. So from this we have from mass and radius of gyration we have I as 22.5. So alpha comes out as 0.933 radians per second square. So this alpha will be negative because the drum is retarding. Okay, now using that relationship that omega, that is your alpha, using that relationship omega f is equal to omega I plus alpha t, because taking omega f as 0 because the drum is coming to rest after applying brake. So final velocity of drum is 0 and initial angular velocity of drum is 2 pi into 200 by 60. So RPM is 200, so omega I is 20.9. So and alpha is 0.933 radians per second square, or this is negative. Okay. So now putting the values, we can find out T. So T comes out as 22.74 radians, or sorry, 22.74 seconds. So the time for the drum to come to rest after applying brake is your 22.74 seconds. Okay. So answer to that question number 12 is 22.74 seconds. Next is where we have to calculate the maximum tension in this next we have to calculate width of the band. If the thickness is 1 mm and stress is 40 newton per meter. So stress is 40 MPa and maximum tension that we have calculated here is T1, that is 336. So and area of the strip will be your B into T. T is given as 1 mm. So equating the maximum tension by equating stress by maximum tension by area. Maximum tension is 336 and T is your 1 mm and sigma is your 40 mm. So B is 8.4 mm. So answer is 8.4 mm. We are assuming it as rectangular, so that's why we are taking area as B into T. Okay. So answer is 8.4 mm. Answer to question number 12 is 22.74 seconds and answer to question number 11 is 21 newton meter.